What's up, Z Nation? I'm Killy here. I am back. I'm sorry for being away for a while because I had to go on vacation and do a bunch of things. So I do apologize for the glimmer in the background or the brightness in the background. I do apologize for that. I seriously need to get better blinds. But anyways, while I was away, the 20th year anniversary for Kingdom Hearts came out. I tried my absolute best to stay, like, legit, my absolute best to stay extremely away from spoilers. So, and thank God I did. Like, yeah, all my favorite YouTubers were posting videos. I had to unsubscribe from them and everything like that. But because they were posting a lot of things on Kingdom Hearts 4 and I'm like on Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts 4 was announced. That's the only thing I know is that Kingdom Hearts 4 was announced. I did not see it though. So, well, that's the only thing I know about Kingdom Hearts is during the 20th anniversary is that Kingdom Hearts 4 was announced. But again, I did not see anything on it. I did not see thumbnails. I did not see anything. So, again, you guys may not know this. Give me a second. Okay, that's a little better. All right. So, you guys may not know this, but I'm a massive Kingdom Hearts fan. I bought the like this came out to, and it was like $500. But I got the collection with the steelbook and also the figurines and stuff like that. I do have a figurine of like the toy box figurine, like the Toy Story World figurines of Sora, Donald, and Goofy. They're both somewhere. I decided to pick up Goofy because he was the closest, and I didn't feel like getting Sora. But I do have the steel box for Kingdom Hearts 3. It's still in its case, by the way. I never used it. It's still in a case, by the way. I still have the promo code. I still have like Union Cross and everything like that. Oh wait, well the disc is gone. I think it came to a friend of mine, the disc, but I decided to keep the steelbook, or maybe it's somewhere around here. I don't even know. The promo code and everything like that is still in its case. So the game is somewhere around here. I don't know where. But again, I did buy the collection with the steelbook and the figurines and stuff like that. But I bought the deluxe edition when Kingdom Hearts 3K was available for pre-order. I pre-ordered it day one and I got the deluxe edition. So yeah. I enjoyed the hell out of Kingdom Hearts 3, by the way. I did this stay away from it too, because I don't know why, but like after I beat the story, I kind of got bored by the game. And I'm a massive idiot for doing this. I'm a massive fucking idiot for doing this. But when Reminded came out, I decided to get back in Kingdom Hearts and get the Platinum Trophy because I platinum everything. I platinum all of the Kingdom Hearts games, everything like that, and I wanted to platinum Kingdom Hearts 3. And I was an idiot for not doing it earlier because I didn't feel like doing it, and I was kind of lazy, and I had to record so many other things. I had recorded and played so many other games, so I decided to give Kingdom Hearts 3 a break, and then play the other games, and then eventually come back to Kingdom Hearts 3 and get the Platinum Trophy. But I'm a fucking idiot for doing that, because when Reminded came out, that's when you get Oblivion and also Oathkeeper. So in order to get, I believe, Oblivion, you had to beat the game on Critical. So, and what's also bullshit about that is that that's because I usually play on the standard, either that or Pro Mode majority of the time, but Critical Mode came out, and once you put Critical Mode in, that's when you can unlock. Once you beat the game, you get Oblivion. But I tried playing on Critical, I kept dying. I can't even beat the first world. I'm not even kidding you guys. I cannot beat the first world, and I didn't feel like replaying the game again. So I decided to say I'm done. So, but I do love Kingdom Hearts. But Kingdom Hearts 2 is my favorite Kingdom Hearts game of all time. I absolutely enjoy the fuck out of Kingdom Hearts 2. It's my favorite Kingdom Hearts game of all time. I have a poster right here of Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, and you guys can really see it because it's behind the camera. But it's a no, it's a wall scroll one. So, and it looks cool because again, I even have a Funko Pop of Kingdom Hearts 2 Sora. So I do not have Kingdom Hearts 3. I was thinking about getting him, but I decided not to. I prefer Kingdom Hearts 2 over Kingdom Hearts 3. But Kingdom Hearts 3 is definitely up there. It's definitely my favorite Kingdom Hearts games. I'd say number 3 or 4. It's Kingdom Hearts 2, then Kingdom Hearts 1. Yeah, Kingdom Hearts 1, then Kingdom Hearts 3, then actually no, scratch that. Kingdom Hearts 2. Yeah, Kingdom Hearts 2, Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts 3, then 3, then Birth by Sleep, then Dream Drop Distance, and then the rest. Honestly, I when it comes to gameplay, I'm putting Chain of Memories like down below. I hated Chain of Memories combat and the fact you had to use cards and like that. I enjoyed the story. Here's the thing: I did enjoy the story for Chain of Memories. I decided to watch a cutscene movie of Chain of Memories instead of just playing the game myself because I was just through the cards. I just could not deal with it, and I just couldn't handle everything like that. So yeah, Chain of Memories is definitely down below. But my top five is Kingdom Hearts 2, Kingdom Hearts 1, Kingdom Hearts 3, Birth by Sleep, and then Dream Drop Distance. That's my that those are my top five. So, anyway, guys, the only Kingdom Hearts games I never played was Union Cross, or Dark Road because I'm not really a mobile gamer. So, I'm not the biggest mobile gamer guy. So if that makes any sense, I just can't handle mobile games. Like I do have games on my phone that I play occasionally, but not as much as I do consoles or anything like that. So, but I know there, I know, and I know there's a there's a bunch of YouTube videos where you can watch the everything on Union Cross up until the new update, and also everything you can watch a cutscene movie on Dark Road and catch up from there. So yeah, I guess we are here for Kingdom Hearts 20th year anniversary announcement trailer. This is my reaction to it, and again, the only thing I know about the anniversary is that Kingdom Hearts 4 was released. That's all I know. I did not see spoilers. I did not see a trailer for it. I did not see anything on it. And in case you, and also guys, you want to know my history? Also, I have put here. Let me see if I can like. Actually, do I have one right here? I think I do. Okay, it's somewhere in here. I have an extra sticker that you also get when you somewhere in there. I do have a sticker in there as well, but like I don't feel like I didn't feel like removing them. But anyway, like I have a sticker for Toy Box, a Kingdom Hearts 3 Toy Box, and it says Kingdom Hearts 3 Monstropolis, and the Kingdom Hearts 3 San Francisco. So because I was gonna put Twilight Town, but the problem is I put Twilight Town on my old computer like cover, and it's in the back somewhere because it was on my old Mac and my Mac broke, so I had to buy a new one and everything like that. It's still on my case, so. Yeah. Anyway, okay, but anyway, my history with Kingdom Hearts. I played Kingdom Hearts back in the PlayStation 2. I believe it was a couple months after it came out. I did not play 1, but I did play 2, and I went to GameStop with my dad because I wanted to get a new game. Actually, before it was GameStop, it used to be EB Games. And you guys remember you gave EB Games? You guys are OGs. Yeah, everyone who remembers EB Games before GameStop, you guys are amazing. But where I used to live before GameStop, it was EB Games, and me and my dad went there because I wanted to get a new game for my PlayStation 2. And I believe before I got Kingdom Hearts, I believe I got. Actually, no. It was right after I got the console. I believe I got the console for my birthday, either for my birthday or for Christmas. It was one of those two. And then my dad said, "Hey Nick, we can go to the game store and get some games." I was like, "Okay, cool, sweet." So me and my dad went to EB Games, and then he says, "Okay, Nick, you can pick out 3 games." I was like, "Okay." So and all those games, I got Star Wars Battlefront 2, not the PS4 version because PS4 didn't come out. I got the PS2 version on the from 2005, which is my favorite Star Wars Battlefront 2, Star Wars, one of my favorites. Okay, it's definitely up there Star Wars games of all time. But we'll talk about that another time. May 4th is legitimately around the corner. It's literally like a week and a half away. So I'm gonna make a separate video on that. And who might even play some Star Wars games during that. I've got Star Wars Battlefront 2 from 2005 on the PS2. Then I got Ratchet and Clank Up Your Arsenal, which is one of my favorite Ratchet and Clank games ever. And then I also got Kingdom Hearts 2. Because the reason I got Kingdom Hearts 2 is because I saw Disney characters were on it. And then back then, I'm a huge Kingdom Hearts fan. Speaking of which, it's almost the 20th year of Lilo and Stitch. The 20th anniversary of Lilo and Stitch is on June, and I'm definitely going to do a trailer reaction and a bunch of our reactions to Lilo and Stitch, because Lilo and Stitch is my favorite Disney movie of all time, at least for me, okay? For me. There's a shit ton of Disney, I love a shit ton of Disney movies, but I legit don't know why, but Stitch, me, him, I feel like I have a great connection with Stitch than any other Disney character. I don't know why. So, yeah, I can't believe it's been 20 years. I was like 4 or 5 when Lilo and Stitch came out, and I got on VHS. I rented it on VHS when it came out, and I enjoyed the absolute fuck out of the movie. So I've seen everything when it comes to Lilo and Stitch. I've seen Lilo and Stitch. I've seen Lilo and Stitch 2, Stitch has a Glitch. I've seen Stitch the movie. I've seen Leroy and Stitch. I've seen the Stitch series. I've seen a shit ton of Stitch stuff. And I also heard that there was an anime, so I might do a reaction to the anime. Who knows? But again, like I've seen everything on Lilo and Stitch. And it's one of my favorites. He's one of my favorite characters, and it's my favorite movie of all time. Anyway, that's beside the point. So again, I saw Disney characters on it, and on the case, I was like, "Ooh, this is like a pretty fun game." And then when I played it, I was instantly in love with it. The visual, like from back then, the visuals and the cinematics were unfucking believable. I enjoyed the fuck out of the story. I enjoyed the fuck out of the characters. I especially loved the combat. And I was just instantly in love with Kingdom Hearts 2. So, and then once I was done with Kingdom Hearts 2, with the story, I decided to get Kingdom Hearts 1, played that, and I was like, okay, this is fun, no, it's not Kingdom Hearts 1, the combat does seem a little meh, and everything like that, and I do love and enjoy the story, but the cinematics on Kingdom Hearts 1 were still amazing. So, and then, I played Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep, and then I got... No, Birth by Sleep came out on the Nintendo DS, didn't it? I think I just played 1 and 2 for a while. And then eventually I did play Birth by Sleep because a friend of mine had it, so I borrowed his copy. Either it was on the PS2 or it was on the DS, I can't really remember. So then I played that, and then I also played Dream Drop Distance when that came out, and then that's when I stopped playing Kingdom Hearts in total. But then once I saw Kingdom Hearts 3 was announced back in 2013, I was like, oh my god, yes! You know, but then we had to wait like 6 years before it came out, we had to wait a long time before Kingdom Hearts 3 came out. So like they keep changing like the style, and they keep changing the engines, and not the engines, but they keep changing the combat and everything like that. But once the official trailer came out, I was like extremely excited. I think I did a trailer reaction for it. I can't really remember, but I was obviously in love with Kingdom Hearts. I'm actually a massive fan of Kingdom Hearts. Again, the only Kingdom Hearts games I never play is Union Cross and Dark Road, because they're mobile games. So that's the reason. All right, guys, I'm gonna shut up. Here we go. Here we go. Oh my god, I'm so excited, guys. Alright, in 3, 2, 1, play. Alright, this is Union Cross Xehanort. Alright, so we got Xehanort, Xehanort, The young Zero made the Master Masters.
Oh my god. Oh my god, the Kingdom Hearts 3.
And they were talking. What's your favorite fairy tale? Master's favorite story. Kingdom Hearts 3, way. Do you stand in my way as a true Kingdom Hearts? No, as a true Kingdom Hearts. Cross Dark Road. August. Yeah, it was. I believe it was delayed or postponed because of COVID. So it's coming out in August. An unwritten era. Okay. Everything is connected.
光と闇から生まれた始まりは心によって育まれた。Like Unreal 4 engine?命は脈々と受け継がれ、時が流れ。やがて世界となった大地は人々の暮らしを作り上げた。ここは光と闇の詰め物と繋がる夢と歪みを持った。
多層都市スカルアドカエルム。
That is Aqua, Sora, Luffy, Kuwana, the kid is Kuwana. Can you customize your character?
Oh my gosh.
It's multiplayer 2? Is it multiplayer 2? Closed beta test in 2022 for iOS. Limited in specific regions, okay? The Lost Master Rock, I think this is it.
Oh my god. The choice is yours once more. Oh my god, Sora! He's awake! Oh my god. Dude, look at him! Look, my boy! Sora, let's see
7 days ago.
Dude, we see his feet!
Quadratum?
Yo, we're in fucking Tokyo, we're in fucking Shibuya!
We saw Sora's feet, by the way. Yo, he's not wearing his clown shoes. Oh my god.
Whoa. Dude, look at this. Is that a dark side?
Yeah, you better get out of there, my boy.
Dude, that does sound so fucking sick.
Dude, the Ray is running.
Keep playing.
timings. Do we have Keyblade transformations? Is it Kingdom Hearts 3? Zora? Look at Ordnance 13. Is that the Master of Masters?
Donald Goofy.
Where are you guys? Where are you guys? I don't know, but I sure hope he can help. Who? Hades? Hey. Just where do you think you're going? Yep, that's Hades. Magic in the making.
Oh my god.
Keep us for eventually a recap video of this event will be available on a later date, okay? Oh my god. Another thing I did see. I just want to go back for a second. I want to go back. Seriously, they really. I know they're using Unreal Engine 5. I believe that's what they're using. Dude, look at these graphics. This is fucking, this is amazing. But first, I was looking up top. Like, I was looking over here, but then all of a sudden I looked up top. I didn't want to pause the video. No. No. I refuse to believe it. I refuse to believe that this is what I think it is. If this is an AT-ST, I'm gonna lose my fucking shit. Are we getting a Star Wars world? Are we getting a Star Wars world? I refuse to believe it. There's no way. There's no way. There's absolutely no freaking way that this is way that this is an AT-ST chicken walker leg or foot. I refuse to believe that this is going to be Endor. Because, like, it's in a forest. The only forest planet that I know is Endor. Dude, if this is what I think, if this is actually true, we've been waiting years for this. The amount of fan art I've seen Sora with a lightsaber keyblade. But what's the timeline though? That's what I want to know. Like, what's gonna be the timeline? Like, is it gonna be the original? Is it gonna be prequel? If this is Endor, then it's the original. How's that gonna work? I don't know how that's gonna work though. I don't know. I legit don't know how that's gonna work. For the original trilogy? Or just Endor in general. I don't know how that's gonna work. Again, like, seriously, the amount of fan arts I've seen with Sora with a lightsaber keyblade. If it's finally happening, I'm gonna lose my mind. Alright. So far, the combat. Look, I want to look at the combat again. But look at my boy. Look at my freaking boy. Just running in, summoning a keyblade, and then, like, dude. Oh, such a good move. Look at this dark side, dude. It looks so good. So, obviously, this has to be the beginning of the game. what we're seeing right now, this has to be the beginning of the game. Because in every single Kingdom Hearts game, in the beginning of every single Kingdom Hearts game, we always had to fight something big, either a dark side or a dark side nobody. I forgot what the Cage 2 one was called. So this has to be the beginning of the game. The fight grapple is amazing. If you do leave this world behind, don't expect to return to the world where you came. I love the way they did that. It looks like a 3, but turns out to a 4. I love the way it looks like eventually it's gonna be 3 from the side, but then it turns into a 4, and I love that. It looks so sick. That was pretty cool. There it is, man. Kingdom Hearts 4. Yzora. God, I can't remember his name. Namora. There you go. What are you gonna give us? I did see the trailer for not the trailer. I did see gameplay. One of my favorite streamers, Murder Birds, when he did. When he did a live stream for Reminded, and when he fought Yzora, when you beat Yzora or you get defeated by Yzora, a cutscene comes up, and he says, "I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real, or not?" That's from KH1, by the way, guys. Like, a lot of people, I know a lot of people have been saying that this game might cross with Versus 13. Like, I know I would, like, a lot of people have been saying, give us Versus 13. Namora, he had to cancel it for some reason. I forgot the reason why. But it was gonna be a Kingdom Hearts with Final Fantasy 15, I believe. I don't even know. Namora, what are you gonna give us with this game? By the way, for my guessing, when this is gonna come out, my guess is probably holiday December of 2023, if not, either fall or winter of 2024. That's my guessing when this game is gonna be releasing, because there's no way in hell he's gonna make us wait another 5 to 6 years before he gives us this game. There's no way. If he's gonna make us wait that long, we don't mind. As long as other Kingdom Hearts games come out, we just saw it with Union Cross and also the Missing Link, before this game comes out. But if you have to wait another 5 to 6 years before Kingdom Hearts 4 comes out, I'm gonna be a little pissed off, just a little bit. But I doubt we're gonna have to wait that long. Probably 2024, either fall or winter of 2024. That is my final guessing. All right, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed my reaction to the Kingdom Hearts 20th year anniversary event. I really do appreciate it. Again, sorry for being away for so long. I really do apologize. I don't know. All right, guys. But I will be live streaming maybe later today, if not tonight. So I definitely will be live streaming. That definitely will happen. So, guys, thank you guys so much for the likes, comments, and all that stuff. I really appreciate it. And I said this before, but I'm just doing this for fun. I'm just doing YouTube and Twitch as a hobby. I would like to be my dream job, but if I'm just doing it as a hobby, that's fine. Like, there's a shit ton of other YouTubers who are doing a way better job than I am. And I've been doing YouTube for the past almost 9.5 years now. And it's been, I really have my ups and downs, a lot of downs lately. And, but I will try my absolute best to get out as much content as possible. But again, I'm just one person. I'm doing everything by myself. Like, I'm doing the editing by myself. I'm recording by myself. Like, the thumbnails are default, everything like that. And plus, I have a lot of responsibilities to do. Like, I'm trying to get my life together. And it just hasn't been easy for me. So, but you guys, I'm gonna go. Sorry for this being a long video. Sorry for this being a long video, I really do apologize, but I just wanted to get out my thoughts and my history with Kingdom Hearts, you know? So I guess, if you guys watched the entire thing, I would really appreciate it, thank you so much. But if you guys, I would definitely put a time code if you guys just wanted to see the reaction and not hear my history with Kingdom Hearts. That's fine, I'll gladly put a time code in the description, if not the comment. So until guys, see you guys in a brand new video, later.